This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. SS Ferret was an iron screw steamship of 460 tons built in Glasgow, Scotland in 1871 by J. The owners that he had substantial financial credentials, and that the cruise was for his wife who was unwell. He claimed to be a relative of W.H. Smith, 1st Lord of the Admiralty. A 6-month lease was agreed, and bills for the first month's charter paid, later to be found worthless. Henderson operated a fraudulent London shipbroking office named Henderson. Traces of his identity. He also told them he owned the ship and was entitled to do with it as he pleased, that he was immensely wealthy, and that anyone who did not cooperate with the scheme would be shot under his instructions. The ship was radically changed in appearance. The yellow funnel was painted black, previously blue lifeboats were painted white, and various items identifying the ship were tossed overboard. The wheelhouse and chartroom were dismantled and rebuilt on the aft deck, further disguising the ship's profile. The ship was renamed Bantam, taking the name of another ship of similar tonnage on the Lloyd's Register, and forged shipping documentation was created to support the false name. The crew were instructed to say the ship had sailed from Singapore. If questioned, the ship next sailed to the Cape Verde Islands and then to Santos, Brazil, where it arrived on Boxing Day 1880. The crew took on a consignment cargo of coffee for Marseille. Henderson then sailed for Cape Town, changing the ship's name en route, for the second time, to India on arrival. He sold the coffee for 13,000 liras. He then sailed for Port Phillip in Victoria, Australia via Mauritius and Albany, Western Australia, arriving at Victoria in April 1881. Henderson told Australian port authorities that he had come from Bermuda. Meanwhile, the owners, Highland Railway Co., had heard nothing of the ship and had advertised its disappearance widely. An observant wharf policeman on duty at Queenscliff, Constable James Davidson, who had recently arrived from Scotland, was at his post as the India steamed past. At the time, he happened to be reading a copy of the Scotsman newspaper, which included an article taken from the Glasgow Evening Citizen and which described the mysterious disappearance of the Ferret from the Clyde. The article read in part, "Vessel lost, stolen, or strayed from the Clyde under this singular heading." The Glasgow Evening Citizen of Saturday prints a curious narrative, of which the following is a summary of the principal statements. About the middle of October last, a gentleman giving the name of Walker called on a leading firm of ship store merchants in Glasgow, represented that he was acting as broker for a gentleman of means who was going on a long yachting cruise, and desired to favor the firm with the contract for the provisioning of the vessel. References were asked, and found to be satisfactory. It was stated that the vessel had been chartered from the Highland Railway Company. It was also given out, more by ambiguous allusion than by direct assertion, that the person for whom Mr. Walker appeared was named Smith, and a relative of the late 1st Lord of the Admiralty. The goods were therefore supplied, including, it is rumored, a large stock of the highest class wines from London. The vessel was then lying at Greenock undergoing an overhaul at the hands of Messrs. Steele & Co., to make her more suitable for the new work and waters in which she was to be engaged for the next 6 months. The name of the vessel is or was the Ferret, and, to give an idea of her appearance, it may be mentioned that she is a screw steamer, 170 feet long, 23 feet broad, and 12 feet deep, having a gross measurement of 347 tons. She is fitted with compound inverted engines of 90 horsepower, having two cylinders of 23 inches and 40 inches diameter. Both vessel and engines were constructed by Messrs. J. and G. Thompson, of Glasgow, in 1871. Seeing that the India fit the description well, Davidson noticed certain unusual behaviors coming from the ship, and noted that it had broken a number of port regulations. His suspicions raised, he kept it under observation and alerted his superiors. Customs officials seized the ship, and the faint appearance of another vessel's name under the lettering India soon confirmed the hoax. Henderson and his accomplices tried to escape but were soon apprehended, charged, and brought to trial by jury in Melbourne before Justice Williams. Henderson, Carleon, and Walker were each charged with conspiracy on the high seas, attempt to defraud the ship's owners, and customs and other maritime offences, including changing the name and official number of a ship. Chief Engineer Griffin, who had been recruited in Glasgow, provided much of the evidence that convicted the three. Watkins, the sailing master, had left the ship in Cape Town, after which Wright had taken over the sailing duties. The three defendants fabricated a story that Watkins had led Peruvian arms smuggling racket, and that he told them to attempt to sell the ship. The court rejected the story and found the three men guilty. Henderson and Walker each received 7 years, and Carleon received 3.5 years in jail. Police investigations later found that Henderson had been offered £8,500 for the ship through Melbourne shipbrokers Duthie. From the master, Captain G.T. Joss, who was cautioned it was wrecked on 14 November 1920 after running onto a beach during a storm at Reef Head near Cape Spencer on the South Australian York Peninsula. All 21 crew were rescued after walking 5 kilometres 31. 1919-1930, State Library of South Australia retrieved 9 July 2009. Shipwrecks and Maritime Incidents in 1920. Shipwrecks 8. September 20.